We will not give up and we will keep on the campaign to ask the Chinese government to admit the mistake, make the apologies, and to rehabilitate the position of their position on the June 4th. Because we think the June 4th is a patriotic and democratic movement for the people in China.
我们身处仍有表达自由的香港，将延续八九民运精神、无负民主先烈的牺牲。自由的香港将延续八九民运精神、无负民主先烈的牺牲。一鞠躬，再鞠躬，三鞠躬。
So I think the whole point of being here is to tell the Chinese government that this is a thing, like you have to apologize for someone else's death. And I don't believe that some of the university students saying that the Hong Kong history has nothing to do with it anymore, and I don't believe in that because it is part of what Hong Kong was, and I think this is part of the process of being democratic, and the process in Hong Kong should include this.
我今日嚟到呢度就係哀悼佢逝者，同埋我哋香港嘅前途，哀悼埋香港嘅前途。
谢谢主持人哈，也谢谢各位。第一个就是我们今年六四表达的是我们对普世人权、普世价值的这种关注；第二一个，我们今年六四表达的是我们对自由民主的制度的捍卫的决心；第三个，我们今年六四也是对中共的一种呛虾，向他表示我们最大的抗议，让他们知道他们曾经犯下的这个罪行，人们是不会忘记。 而且我相信这三个意义啊，是台湾能够走向一个更民主的社会不可或缺的理念。那么在最黑暗的时候，也许中共会更进一步的加强对社会的压制。最近的李明哲事件就是一个代表。但是通常在最黑暗的时刻，
可能也就是光明的一个开始。那对于我们来说，更重要的就是坚持。一点，他是在武汉事件，武汉事件是一个村委会，就是集体把一个村老婆跟他的妻子留下。那他是2010年诺贝尔和平奖的得主。那大家如果有印象的话，他是第三。那后来的2014年的时候，他有一个那个跟原。我的思念一条条不走。其中那永远。